Located at the Galleria Mall in Cheektowaga.
Welcome back, everybody. Usually when we speak with Dr. Salvatore Guttadauria from Diversified Services, we are talking about the benefits of hearing aids. But this morning, you know what? We're going to approach this from another direction. Let's talk about the facts when dealing with a decline in hearing. Dr. Guttadauria, once again, is the CEO of Diversified Services. Welcome back.
Thank you for having me
again. And you know, we don't think too much about all the things that you lose when you lose hearing, but first thing first is cognitive decline.
Yeah,
this is all proven stuff.
This is proven stuff. It has been a recent publication by Starkey Hearing Foundation, and this stuff is new, but we've known it for a long time. There can be up to a 30 to 40% quicker increase in cognitive decline than a counterpart who has hearing aids than without hearing aids.
And tell us, what's cognitive decline?
If you want to think about it as your thinking skills or your processing skills, your ability to be able to figure things out.
Well, you know, you don't use it, you lose it.
That's exactly right.
And that's it, in layman's terms.
Yeah, so a lot of times we think of cognitive decline in somebody who has dementia or Alzheimer's disease is how we think of it. But certainly, everybody needs stimulation. And if you take away that stimulation, you're not stimulating those parts of the brain that need to be stimulated.
Okay, also tinnitus or tinnitus, that is a problem.
Yeah, it's a problem. 90% of the people who have hearing loss also experience tinnitus or tinnitus. Mm-hmm. And it's, for some people, it's a real problem because it keeps them awake at night. They concentrate on it. They have a hard time working through it. So it's truly a problem. And by the way, when you're amplified, when you do have hearing aids, hearing aids have special programs in there that will help decrease the sound of the tinnitus.
Yeah, see, a lot of people, I don't think, know that. They might think, well, a hearing aid will only make me hear the tinnitus worse, but that's not true.
Absolutely not. It helps to cover up the sounds that you don't want to hear with the good sounds that you want to hear.
Also, higher incidences of depression and isolation. That makes sense.
Doesn't it make sense? Mm-hmm. You have somebody who can't communicate well anymore, that can't participate in conversation, that can't participate in family gatherings. Those people tend to withdraw, and there's lots of studies for many years that have shown that those people tend to be more depressed.
Right, and they just kind of start getting quiet and they just start not taking part in conversations, and that's why a lot of times you don't even link it to something like hearing loss. And the fact is, shorter lifespan.
Yeah, when you combine all of these factors and all of these stresses that that hearing loss has, it leads to a shorter lifespan for people who are not amplified. Now, we need more studies in this, and we need to see how to make things better. But what the new research is showing is that if you can fix some of these issues, if you can make people hear again, you're going to take away a lot of those stresses.
And let's also bring this one in, because I'm sure there are people who will identify with this, greater incidences of falling when you have hearing loss that's not corrected.
Mm-hmm. And you would think, what the heck does hearing loss has to do with falls? But it does. I mean, they have study upon study now that are showing that you have a greater increase in falls if you have a hearing loss than if you don't have a hearing loss. Mm-hmm. So, and remember what happens with falls. I mean, falls are life-changing experiences for many of the elderly people.
Yes. Listen, what can we say? We can send you to a Diversified office near you. They are all over Western New York, 9 locations. Please call the main number, 871-9915. Log on to diversifiedhearing.com. As I always say after these segments, it can change your life.